Learning to combine text and shapes in creative imaging can help users communicate their designs more effectively. To begin, let's create a new document. Go to the File menu, then select New. After selecting the 5-inch by 5-inch preset, click on the OK button. In the Layers panel, create a new layer and rename it Badge. Afterwards, go to the Tools panel and select the Elliptical Marquee tool. On the Badge layer, drag the mouse pointer to draw a circular selection. This is going to be the outline of the badge that we're about to create. The next thing we want to do is fill it with the color by going to the Edit menu, selecting Fill. Then in the Fill dialog box, click on the Use drop-down arrow and select Color. Choose your desired color. Then select the OK button. Select OK once again. Then back on the canvas, click on the Select menu and deselect. Next, we're going to create a path using the Shape tool. Go to the Tools panel and select the Ellipse tool. Then in the Options bar, click on the Paths icon. Bring your cursor to the canvas. Draw a circular path inside of the colored circle, leaving enough room for the desired text to appear along the outside of the path. To reposition the circular path, go ahead and use the space bar and then resize accordingly. Now to type along the path, go to the Tools panel and select the Type tool. In the Options bar, let's change the font size to about 48. Now hover your mouse pointer along the circular path until a squiggly line appears through the Type tool pointer. Then click once and then start typing. Highlight the text that you just created. Then back in the Options bar, let's change the font type to Ravi or whatever you'd like. Let's go back to the Options bar and select the Character panel. In the Character panel, click on the drop-down arrow to edit the tracking of your text to negative 50. This is going to decrease the space between each letter. When finished, click on the Character panel's flyout menu and select Close Tab Group. Click anywhere on the text to deselect it. To rotate your text, hold down the Control key, then hover your mouse just outside the corner of the I-beam until it turns into a double arched arrow, then drag your I-beam in order to rotate your text. Now let's create the text that's going to go on the bottom of our badge. Let's first click on the type layer to show what's on that type layer, which is the word choose. Then right-click on the Choose Type layer and select Duplicate layer. Click OK. Then back on the canvas, click inside the text. Let's rotate this new type layer by holding down the Control key once again, hovering over the corner, and then dragging it in order to rotate it. Let's select the text in our new type layer. Then retype love, not war, or whatever you'd like. Let's rotate this type layer again. As you can see, our new type layer is a little bit too large for our badge. So let's click and select our new text. Then back in the Options bar, let's change the font size to 40. Then click on the text to deselect it. Let's rotate it once again. and then drag the text to the inside of the path. Go ahead and rotate your text to reposition it on the badge, and drag your entire I-beam to change the position of the text. You'll have to keep rotating and resizing your I-beam in order to get your text just right on your badge. Just remember that your type tool cursor has to be active inside of your text in order for the I-beam to be activated. Now let's change the color of our text. Let's select our text, Love Not War. Then in the options bar, click on the color swatch and change your text color to whatever you want. When finished, click on the OK button. Now let's change the color of our other type layer, Choose. Click on your text to activate your cursor. Then highlight the entire text before going to the options bar and clicking on the text color swatch. Once again, change the color of your text to whatever you want. Then when finished, click on the OK button. Let's unhighlight our text to see the changes. Let's add some more design to our badge by right-clicking on the Shape tool and selecting Custom Shape tool. Let's go to the Options bar and click on the Shape gallery and select any custom shape by double-clicking on it. Make sure in the options bar that the shape icon is selected, because remember we used the shape tool to create a path before, so you have to change it back. Let's click on the color swatch to set the color for our new custom shape. Then after you're done selecting your color, click on the OK button. Now you're ready to draw your custom shape. Again, holding down the Shift key while drawing your custom shape will keep it proportionate. Now back in the Layers panel, click on the Badge layer. Select the Add Layer Style icon on the bottom of the Layers panel, and select Bevel and Emboss. Let's select the Layer Style dialog box, and drag it over so that we can see our image as we work on it. First, let's drag the size slider to about 75. Then select the soften slider and drag it to about 16. Then let's add a drop shadow to our badge by selecting the drop shadow under the styles menu. First, let's change the distance to about 15 pixels. Then the spread slider to about 12. Then lastly, let's increase the size of our drop shadow to about 13. Let's uncheck the preview checkbox to see the before and after. If you're satisfied with your changes, click on the OK button.